Hi children, today we are going to begin first poem of class 11th course, that is a photograph by Shirley Tolson. Shirley Tolson was born on 20th May in the year 1924 in England. She was editor of magazines. She is the leading authority on ancient tracks and drove roads, and is the author of the famous books The Drovers, Roads of Wales and Drovers, Roads of South Wales. Now, we are going to start the poem. This poem is a tribute to her mother. It takes us down in the memory lane. It delights us as well as brings glooms or sadness. The poem contrasts the eternal state of nature and transitory state of human beings. It describes us about three stages of human life. In the first stage, the photograph shows the poet's mother standing at beach enjoying her holiday with her two cousins when she was just 12 years old. In the second part, the poetess takes us some 20 or 30 years later time. Here, the mother again looks at the photograph. First, she laughed at the photograph and then she felt disappointed at the loss of her childhood days and enjoyment. In the third stage, the poetess remembers the dead mother with a heavy heart. The photograph revives a nostalgic feelings in the poetess. Her mother is dead for nearly as many years as that girl in the photograph lived. Now, the sea holiday was her mother's past, while her mother's laughter has turned to be the poetess' past now. Now, due to this painful silence of the situation, she has no words to express on her grief. Thus, the poetess pays the silent and the solemn tribute to her mother through this poem. Let's now know about the poem. The cardboard shows me how it was when the two girl cousins went paddling, each one holding one of my mother's hand, and she, the big girl, some 12 years or so. Cardboard means the stiff paper board on which the photograph is pasted. Here in this poem, the poetess is looking at the old photograph of her mother which was pasted on the cardboard. And this photograph recalls the old memories of her mother's childhood before her. And the photograph depicts her mother's sea holiday with her two cousins who were younger to her, each one holding one of her mother's hand, and she, the big girl, some 12 years or so, her mother's age. During this sea holiday time, it was nearly some 12 years when this sea holiday was enjoyed by her with her two younger cousins. All three stood still to smile through their hair at the uncle with the camera. The photograph shows that the poet's mother with her two cousins, they were all standing still and giving the smiling pose to the uncle when their photograph was clicked. As the weather was windy, so their hair was flying over their smiling faces. The expression on their faces was full of happiness and enjoyment. A sweet face, my mother's, that was before I was born. The poetess recalls that her mother looked quite pretty when the photograph was taken. And the sea, which appears to have changed less, was their terribly transient feet. The poetess says here that everything has changed since then. Her mother grew up and she is no more in the life, And the poet is reviving her memories. But the only thing that has remained unchanged is the sea, which has washed the footmarks of all these three young girls standing in the photograph. The word transient here stands for the temporary or the thing which lasted for a few moments. So it indicates the ever-changing lives of human beings as well as the short stay of the human beings in this world in contrast to the eternal nature. Thus, the girl's life also changed drastically during this period now. But the sea has not changed till now. Next stanza, some 20-30 years later, she would laugh at the snapshot. See Patty and Dolly, she would say, and look how they dressed us for the beach. Here in these lines, the poetess now describes her mother's feeling with us. She says how even after the lapse of 20-30 years, her mother, she used to laugh at the snapshot. Snapshot, that means photograph. So, looking at this photograph, she nostalgically remembers the happy moments of her past and used to comment about the dressing sense of theirs during her childhood. Patty and Dolly, she would say, and look how they dressed us for the beach. After looking at the photograph, the mother used to laugh and comment on the dress worn by the cousins Betty, Dolly and herself at that joyful moment. The sea holiday was her past minus her laughter. Just like the sea holiday, it turned to be the mother's past now. For the poetess, the mother's laughter has become a thing of past because the mother is no more in the life. Both try with the labored ease of loss. The poetess says that this photograph reminds the sea holiday of her mother with fondness as well as the sense of loss for the mother because that time could never be called back by the mother. In the similar way, the poetess feels nostalgic about her mother and her laughter, which has also become the thing of past due to the death of her mother. But try with the labored ease of loss. Rai stands for the expression of disgust or depression. The poetess here comments about the losses related to two different people at the different situations. In the first one, it is related to her mother about the fondest memories of her lost childhood. And the second one is related to the poetess herself about her beautiful mother and her lovely laughter. She says both these situations carry the beautiful memories, but they turn to be painful as the time has slipped away these moments between them. So it become painful to now bear these losses and recover from them. So that's why she said it will take the labored ease of loss, that it is very difficult, it is not easy to undergo those losses and have their recovery in the present life. Let's conclude. See the last stanza. Now she has been dead nearly as many years as that girl lived. The poetess is now standing nearby the childhood photograph of her mother and recalls that it is near about 12 years ago her mother had left the world. And of this circumstance stands for the situation, that is the tragedy of her mother's death, which has created the grimful situation and left the girl lonely and depressed in life now.
That's why he told, there is nothing to say at all. It's silence, silences. That means the painful silence created by the death leaves everyone speechless and silent. We all are helpless before death, as we can't make the recovery due to the losses created by the death in life.
Before leaving, I want to tell you how this poetess finds her mother's death to be loud and inspiring enough to pour her feelings in the form of a tribute of this poem. Now let's explore the literary devices used here. First is alliteration. That means the repetition of the initial letters. See here, the words are stood still. Through their, my mother's, terribly transient, silence, silences. So this is the use of alliteration. Then next is oxymoron. Oxymoron is the literary device where the opposite ideas are joined to create the effect. So see the words, labored ease. So this is the example of oxymoron. Labored means with great difficulty, and ease means comfortably. So both words have opposite meanings. So the next one, transfer epithet. Transfer epithet is a description which refers to a character or event, but used to describe a different situation or character. See the words, transient feet. So this is the example of the transferred epithet. It means the human feet, but also describe the lack of permanence of human life. So everyone, for watching the video.
Now last one is personification. When you find the poet has put the life into some lifeless objects with the use of the words. See the word, the silence, silences. So this is all the explanation about this poem. I hope you have understood the poem very thoroughly. Thank you everyone.